Viruses come in many different shapes and they have like our proteins in their membranes. In the capsid protein, RNA, and DNA. I don't know, influenza, bacteria phase. The capsid enters the cell and disintegrates. Then the DNA or RNA replicates and eukaryotes get in the nuclear membrane. Takes over the cell to make its own progeny. Viruses come on in, mRNA's transcripted. It helps make proteins that are in the capsid. New DNA is wrapped up, replicated and packed up. Takes over host cell, split it, and after attacks, lytic, lysogenic, cycles for the virus, lysogenic, the host cell splits, it binding fission, bacteriophages, get it to bacteria, prophages form inside, viral DNA is dormant, bacteria splits up, it is called transduction, the virus gets inside, bacteria begins lysis and it pops, cells lysingle, pop, when the virus switches to the lytic cycle, viruses touch down, all cells that are found, airborne or water or in the ground, they jump around,
viruses spread through contact directly,
receptors found,
they're classified in different families,
they jump around,
cell walls they can get in between,
split up, the host cells now.
Bacteria may keep some of the info from viruses and their DNA. If you track it back a long time, you see remnants of them in our DNA base.
Bacteria have circular chromosomes. DNA is inside where proteins are coded. Peptides look like inner cell walls, phospholipid bilayers. Gram negative stain pink, gram positive purple. Any DNA from outside can be transferred. And the bacteria is used in transformation occurs. Gram negative has two, gram positive only one. Phospholipid bilayers from outside for protection. Fibrilla like glue help stick to other cells. Flagella help it move to its destination. Sex pillars transfer plasmids for real. Conjugation takes place. New genes help bacteria kill. Resistance is found. All plasmids around. They float real free and get around.
They jump around. Viruses spread through contact directly.
Receptors found.
They're classified in different families.
They jump around.
Cell walls they can get in between.
Split up the host cells now.
Bacteria may keep some of the info from viruses and their DNA. If you track it back a long time, you see remnants of them in our DNA bases.
Bacteria, auto and heterotrophs, light and CO2 are used by photoautotrophs. Bacteria help uptake nutrients like N and K. Mutualistical plants help them grow up straight. Chemoheterotrophs and camphors that are organic. Facultative anaerobes can switch, use O2 when it's around, survive when it's out. Halophiles, thermophiles in archaea domain. Transduction will get ya, transformation will get ya. Conjugation can cause antibiotic resistance. Your immune system down when they are around. Flagella propel them free to move around.
They jump around.
Bacteria spread through contact directly.
Receptors found.
Classified with genus and species.
They jump around.
Your immune system's where they can be.
Binary fission now.
Bacteria may keep some of the info from viruses in their own DNA. If you track it back a long time, you see remnants of them in our DNA bases.
This is dedicated to evolution. See, viruses can take that material, cause the bacteria to change, get those genes passed down over time, and pretty soon you got resistance everywhere. And that's evolution. Changing genes, changing populations. The viruses and bacteria rule the world.